So this topic, we're going to talk about the filter. Although filter, like a capacitor filter and LC filter for simple Wi-Fi are really straightforward simple. We did get actually cater for the filter learning for the power factor correction. So normal AC is easy for us as a simple format with just simple Wi-Fi with a capacitor or with an LC filter. But more advanced version will use PFC power factor correction to enhance the input current performance and make the model by sine wave. But before we learn that, I'd like you to understand more about the simple filter. Although simple capacitor filter is learned in the dark. In very straightforward, like this one. AC input, when you go to a bridge rectifier, then the most simple AC to DC rectifier will be just putting a capacitor. I think you all know about it. And in this step, when you're using this one, many students like to change this capacitor into very large value in order to reduce the voltage ripple between them. So the larger the better. Of course, they will cost you more. But the thing is coming to what's the limit? How much you can do? Of course, in theory, you can put so large so that you can reduce the ripple to legible, but there will be some drawback. I'm going to show you what it is. So that means in this chapter, we're going to show you what's the design criteria for the capacitor, what's the limitation, what's the drawback, what's the further improvement. So one thing you do will be, what's the best method to choose the capacitor? What's the limitation? And then how do you see the disadvantages if you use very big capacitor? So the key thing you want to study here. Of course, for all these analysis, I put some simple assumption. Like we show that the output current, low current is equal to a constant value, and the power losses in the capacitor and diode are small and manageable. That will be easier for our calculation. First of all, this is the typical waveform you see for simple rectifier capacitor effect. So you see that the sine wave after full the bridge rectifier will be the uniform sine wave all rectifier on one side of the polarity. And the capacitor will provide the decoupling. So mainly it will charge up in this region. When the sine wave goes to capacitor voltage, off voltage, it charge up. And then when the AC input voltage drops due to the sine wave property, then the capacitor still have voltage here will be charged slowly by the output current. So when the output current drops to this somewhere this point, the input sine wave already rise up to this point, and then we start to charge up again. And then after that, for the peak value, 90 degrees, it starts to decrease again. So that's a typical waveform you can see. Obviously, you can see that the charging part of the capacitor only this narrow region, only above this region. So definitely, all this region will provide them with a capacitor current to provide it with the charging. Let's not assume output current very much constant. So after the, in this portion, the capacitor is being discharged, provide you with the output current. So the capacitor current will be constant negative part. This is the capacitor current provided with the load. And after that, you will continue to charge again. Obviously, you can see that the capacitor current will be pulsational, this kind of pulse. Another observation you can see that will be the balance of the charge. What question is know about the charge balance in the capacitor? I think when you in the past when you learn about the buck converter or other converter, you got something called the work second balance. That means for all the inductor, the work second or the voltage on the time will balance between positive and negative. But for the theoretical principle, then your capacitor, then the charge also balance. So that's a charge in, that's a charge out. These two charge under the steady state must be equal and opposite, so that the charge will be balanced, but the average charge for capacitor under the steady state will be zero. That will say that the low net charge will continuously to charge the capacitor to infinity voltage. So that means if you look at all this table, these two must be equal and opposite. So if you look at the waveform and see that, this must be equal and opposite in the area. So now comes the problem. will be the capacitor needs to use just a very narrow period of the time to charge up. So that is to say, all the current which is focused in the capacitor, if you use very large capacitor, you end up with this ripple, therefore becomes small, because it's charged slowly. This region, charging region, will be very narrow, then that means this pulse curve getting even bigger. Usually if low current is say 1 amp, this can be 10 times. And if this is 10 amp, it can be 100 amp without any surprises. So that's the problem, because the capacitor, if the current is too large, then of course EMI will be a problem, age of the capacitor problem. So we don't want that. Even though the power loss will be higher, because our average current will also higher, because there are not the harmonics. So we don't want that. So now then we need to see what is the solution to this one, what is the limitation. We don't think we can change this one. It's a simple capacitor, but we try to understand more about it. So let's say you can see that this capacitor current. So the input sine current will be like that. So the capacitor like that. So the sound sine current is equal to the capacitor current acting the output current. Acting output current. Yeah. So that's why I can see that in here. For the downside current, this current adding the down current will equal to the down current. So, current current adding output current equal to the down current. So it looks like this thing shift up to here will therefore become your down current. So this also that means the input down current also has a very sharp pulses. So that means the down also under the pressure. Input current because down bridge. So this unipolar current will therefore change into bipolar in the conventional manner of the down bridge. So that's why input must be AC anyway. So that's a common typology. So the key thing is now, input the current in the AC side will be pulsational. Obviously, the power factor is poor. The GC for the harmonic thing will be poor. When the capacitor is getting high up, this will be even worse. So let's look at the equation. Because firstly, I want to find out about the ripple in here. Firstly, this ripple is important. I want to calculate this ripple. I also want to calculate the average voltage output. I also want to calculate and all the features in here so that I can calculate this current, input current as well. So we can solve a number of equations in here. So firstly, let's look into that. The voltage ripple is just simply by our conventional capacity equation C dV dt. So our conventional capacitor equation, I used to do that, C dV dt equal to I. So now then, the dV is the ripple here, is that dV, the ripple. The ripple is therefore equal to current over C multiplied by I. So the current, of course, is our output current, because that's the current to discharge the capacitor. The time here, the charge time, you can see from the waveform, this is the time to discharge. So this is equal to one quarter period. From 0 to this t dash is the time I put down in here. So total time of discharge will equal to one quarter period. So that means the capacitor equation will be like that, the delta voltage, current over capacitance, and multiplied by time. This is one quarter period. and also the voltage at the point of the intercept, end of the discharge, you can see that equal to peak voltage of the sine wave minus the ripple. So this is the peak voltage of the sine wave. Minus the delta V will equal this voltage, V dash, at the time you have T dash. So this is enough. Then we can get to this equation. Of course, the V dash is equal to a conventional sine wave equation at the time of T dash. T dash is the time to give you the V dash. So now then we build the equation. These three equations, we can merge together, will give you this equation. Quickly, one equation, you can solve for the value for T dash. So that will say C for capacitor filter, this is given. Voltage V dash will be given naturally 20 volt multiplied by root 2. And our current is given. Frequency of 2 times F. F will be 50 Hz. So for whole equation, everything is provided. All you need to do is calculate for T dash. But however, you can see that that's not a simple way to calculate because there's not a, there's a sign in here. So it's not easy to calculate. There's no simple method to calculate for the T. You cannot put T on one sign as a subject and calculate the whole equation. So you must use iteration. So that will say you need to put some unit value after a few iterations, then you know the T dash. Later on in the tutorial, I'll show you how that can be done. So next thing on the calculate will be the capacitor current. If capacitor current pulsation, no? I'm going to calculate how it looks like. So go back to the basic. Like the capacitor current, you will see dvdt. Which depends the voltage. What's the voltage? V sine omega t. The basic sine wave voltage. So we differentiate this one, you can get the capacitor current equal to this one. So this is quite important, you can use it to look into the capacitor current waveform and also the charge. Next thing, I want to look into the charge balancing. I just told you the area under the curve of capacitor will be equal in the positive negative side. So in the positive side, then that is the capacitor current. I integrate from T dash to 1/4 period. So where is this region will be equal to, then from this region, we integrate from T dash into 1/4 period, so that is the time for the capacitor to increase with the charge. So this charge will equal to the electric charge. This electric charge is just rectangle, so we can just use the duration, which is upper current multiplied by the time, which is here, the time is here, will therefore equal to the beta, which again equal to 1/4 period, the T dash. So that's why you also equate these two to together to understand the charge balancing. So that's all the equation for the simple C capacitor. So again, other points I have already mentioned, the down current equal the summation for the capacitor current plus the IL is low current. AC waveform is an AC sign which must be bipolar. It's actually equal to the bipolar format of the down current. So now then give a quick tutorial so that you see if you're able to do that. So we ask you to design a C capacitor in 4 parameter. So upper and low current equal 10 amp. If capacitor is 2000 μF, you go to 240 volt. And source frequency is 50 Hz. So you ask you to calculate all the parameters for that filter, including the upper voltage or the ripple voltage and the capacitor current to calculate all this. So other than the calculation, if now we change the capacitor to 5000 micro, we do the calculation, please. Okay, I think you are doing it to do the work. So To deal with this answer, then we firstly reconstruct the equation first. So the T test equation, if we put all the parameters here, will therefore become this equation. So to do this one, you need to provide you with iteration. So for example, right, we put the T, you need to get what T test in here. After you get the new value and then get the new to put it here, and after two iteration, you should be able to get the answer. But bear in mind there are two methods to get the iteration. Firstly, you can use this expression to do the iteration, or you can rearrange the equation using this T as the subject of the equation to get the answer. So either way, I don't know which way is better, one of the way may not get the iteration answer, and either way would get the answer. So you try this one, or we configure the equation using this T dash to become the subject of the equation. So if you do that, then you should be able after the iteration to do the answer. I only prepare a this already been prepared. Assume we got 10N in here, 2000, 240 volt and 50 hertz, omega is 2 by F, then I firstly initial guess, I will put T test equal to about 3 milliseconds, put in the equation to the iteration, and then eventually I can get the T test is equal to this value. And then I put back into here to get the this value. So you can see that after a few cycles, then the value will become a stable, don't need to be many times. Oh, this is first order iteration. Then after a few cycles, the T dash will become fixed value 0.034. Only three cycles will give the value. So this value will give your capacitor current to be 103 A. And then of course the other current, I adding the low current become the input current. The delta V, the ripple, just using our equation, we can therefore get to the ripple to 42 volt. The output, what I'm trying to do will be half of this voltage minus the peak voltage will give you the end output voltage. So you see that the ripple of 13.3%. So again, this even though first order iteration, you can really quickly get to the answer. So next question is to ask will be, if you change the capacitor to 5000 mF, what happens? Let's do that on the computer. Then again, you will see that after a few iterations, also three iterations, I get a new T dash, and the current of IC 170, and also the input current 180. So you can see that compared to previous one, we go up to 110 A, but now go up to 180. It's quite a big value, given that the output current only 10 A. So in any case, the capacitor current or the input current talking about more than 10 times or in this case 18 times. So this is a very serious problem. The output voltage ripple, although it's now become 5.4%, the ripple just now was 42 volt, is now reduced to about 18 volt. So higher value of capacitor, I'm sure can reduce the ripple. If the ripple is smaller, then actually the actual voltage will also increase slightly. And the ripple also small. So the thing we don't pipeline will be the current, the pulse current is too large. So that's the key disadvantage for this kind of power converter. Some students may like to ask me how do we get the value? Because I put 0.03 as the initial guess, can I put other value? Then of course, I didn't set with 3 milliseconds. But if the initial guess, because the peak value is 5 milliseconds, somewhere the T dash should be something around 3 milliseconds, would be a good guess. For all the iterations, you still need to guess the initial value. So here we here, I just want to guess 3 times. Then you can also repeat about 3 cycles. Then you also go back to the iteration stable. So the initial batch is not that important. Of course, you don't beyond the 90, 0 to 90 in green anyway. So I guess if you put down 0.0028, I think you can also get to the answer quite quick. Okay? So that's it. You can see that the key conclusion will be our IC current for this 1003 amp compared to 10 amp for about 10 times, which is not quite less. And then the input current 103 amp, delta V, just using our equation calculator, is 42 volt, which we can see that our average output is 318 volt, is the peak value minus half of the delta V. And then continue with that, if we increase the 5000 mF, then the new iteration time will be 0.00396S, new current about 170 amps, is really large, 17 times larger. And the ripple will now reduce to 18 volt. So that's why you can see that capacitor filter is good, but I don't like the ripple. We have intermediate mind to the input side, which we need to find a way to solve the problem. So of course, the next thing we need to improve that, we can reduce the ripple by using a more filter. For example, I put an inductor there, because we know that inductor can actually reduce the ripple anyway.